Welcome to the 2017 IMPD Retiree Luncheon. Would you please stand for the presentation of the colors by the Chief's Honor Guard? Would you please join me in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. Good morning. I am Sergeant Kendall Adams, and on behalf of Mayor Joe Hogsett, Deputy Mayor David Hampton, Chief Brian Roach, and the entire IMPD command staff, we welcome each of you to the IMPD Retiree Luncheon honoring our 2017 retirees. I'm honored and humbled to be here today on behalf of the 2,000 employees of IMPD to say thank you for your service to the city and our beloved department. I indulge to say that our city is safer and our department stronger because of your service. Okay, what would a retirement ceremony be without a joke? So here it goes. All right, so a man was stopped by an IMPD around 2 a.m. The officer, whose name was Mike Bates, asked him where was he going this time of night. The man replied, "I'm on my way to a lecture about alcohol abuse and the effects it has on the body, as well as smoking and staying out late." The officer then asked, "Really? Who's giving that type of lecture this time of night?" The man replied, "That would be my wife." All right, I tried. Chief, don't fire me. Give me a break. Before we bring up our chaplain to offer the invocation, I would like to thank all of our supporters and sponsors who, without their continued support, this ceremony and this day would not be possible. The support of our supporters continues to allow us to honor our service of our retirees in an honorable and dignified way. First, I'd like to start with Debbie and Mike Laird, the Jake Laird Memorial Fund. Debbie and Mike could not be here with us today, but we would like to not only acknowledge their continued support and sponsorship, but their printing of both the invitations and the programs before you. As many of you know, Officer Jake Laird was killed in the line of duty back in 2004, and Debbie and Mike have poured more than $720,000 into this local community. Next, I would like to acknowledge Jeannie Johnson, Rod Harrard, and James Trout with the Indianapolis Power and Light, Danny Overly, Tom Cotton, and Pam Cotton, Professional Police Officers Credit Union, Rick Snyder and Bill Owensby, FOP Lodge 86, Liz Allison, IMPD Recognition Fund, Ed Merchant and Martin Brown, Rocco House Councilman Blackwell, Bemis, and Hasbrook, David Roth, Police and Firemen's Insurance Association. And I must be getting an addition to that program. Tony Lorenzo with TL Enterprises. Tony is not able to join us today, but we would like to acknowledge his continued support. Ted Fries and Jim Campbell with the Indianapolis Motor Speedway and the Speedway Police Department. Matthew and Laverne Stewart with Stewart Speaker Series, who, if I'm not mistaken, will host former Attorney General this evening, where our chief will be present as well. Let's give all of our supporters and sponsors a round of applause. Ms. Donna, did I miss someone? Okay, I just want to make, that's my boss right there, so I have to make sure I get everybody. All right, so next I would like to acknowledge the command staff and thank them for their support, who most of are here today. Obviously, Chief Brian Roach, who's here. Chief, you want to raise your hand? Everybody knows you. Assistant Chief Randall Taylor, who I think is here.
Yes, sir.
Deputy Chiefs Chad Connect, Valerie Cunningham, and Jim Waters, over here to my left. Commanders, Roger Spurgeon, Chris Bailey, Michael Jefferson, very good. Josh Barker, very good. Phil Burton, thank you. Don Snyder, and Michael Spears, the Godfather. I call him the Godfather, Foreign Chief. And I think our some of our majors here, Eric Kinch, saw him, Susan Hill, Kevin Wellington, Lorenzo Lewis, and Richard Riddle. Did I see him earlier? Tom Sellis. Very good. Jim Cleek, I missed a couple. There you go, Jim Cleek. I'm definitely fired after today. Any other majors that I missed? All right, let's give them a round of applause. Yeah. I know, Chief, I'm fired, I can tell. Before we serve lunch, I would like to extend a thank you to a few people, Ms. Sarah Haas with Pipers at the Marott and her staff for this beautiful decorum. Please remain seated while Sarah and her staff release the tables to be served. I would like to invite Senior Chaplain Pat Holman to the podium to offer the invocation. Did I see her? No, there she is. There you go.
Good morning. If you would please join me in an attitude of prayer. Oh God, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Lord, for this occasion. We thank you, Father God, for the many people in this room who sacrificed an abundance of years in the service of this city. We thank you, Lord, because they alone were able to hold the line and keep this city safe. We thank you and honor you and ask now that you would continue, Lord, to bless their health, to bless their finances, to bless their homes and their families. That the time now be a joyous time. And then, Lord, we thank you for those who gave to put this function on. We thank you, Father God, for their sacrifice as well. Now we ask that you would bless the food that has been prepared for us. May it be used for the nourishment of our bodies, as your word is nourishment for our souls. In his name we pray, amen.
Can anyone guess how many combined years is leaving the department in 2016?
43.
Somebody said 46?
No, 43. I don't know.
43? Wow. Wow. Chief, do you have a guess?
Over 700.
Over 700 years. Let's give that a round of applause. That's impressive. 700 years. Before we proceed, I'd like to invite the mayor up. Mayor Joe Hogsett to offer brief remarks.
Well, good afternoon. I noticed in the introduction, Kendall emphasized the word brief. You know, we were talking at lunch about the fact that over 700 years of experience is being acknowledged and recognized today. And I made the observation that that's quite a hole. So much of a hole that I told the table that I was going to dispense with my prepared remarks and engage in an altar call. Reverend Hampton, you can help me. Engage in an altar call and see how many people I can get back into the congregation. And the table uniformly said, probably not too many takers. Well, look, I do want to at least spend a moment how enormously honored and grateful I am as mayor to be with you on this special day. All of you, whether civilian or sworn, have embodied a spirit and an attitude that makes Indianapolis the special place that it is. Our community is more safe, it is more secure because of your commitment, your willingness to go above and beyond the call of duty at times. I know that you are proud of your service, and you should be. You've gone where many of us never dare to go. You've mentored younger officers, younger employees with invaluable lessons, and you've done those things without really any sort of glitz or glamour, and certainly not a stellar salary. Although I see our lodge president of the FOP, we made some progress this year. But what I am most proud of is the fact that you have done all those things and been motivated by your desire to serve the ideal of the greater good, the betterment for your neighbors, for your families, for your loved ones, for your community. And at the end of the day, that's what binds all of us together, does it not? So the road behind you is and has been long, exhausting, demanding, and I truly hope that now the road ahead for those of you we honor today is one of relaxation, happiness, peace, good health, because those are things that you all have rightfully earned. Allow me, if I might, for just a moment, to be so presumptuous so as to speak on behalf of each and every citizen of Indianapolis, so that I may, on their behalf, say thank you. And may all of your lives be filled with prosperity as you move on to new endeavors, having served as an integral part of the finest police force that we could ever hope for. Thank you, and may God bless each and every one of you.
powerful. I would like to invite Chief Roach to the podium to offer his brief remarks.
So I can be brief. So Kendall's been fired twice today. I'm going to fire him again because I've got to go after the mayor. But I just wanted to talk about a couple things. Number one, my my kids and my wife are beating me up at this point in my life because I never went home and told the stories about anything that ever happened at work. And some of you may have a different relationship with your family. Maybe they know all those things. But I would encourage you, before you get too old, to write down some of those experiences that you've had because they're very meaningful. They don't seem to, while we're going through the career, to mean that much to us or be that significant to us. But I guarantee you the people that were on the other side of your care and concern, it was significant to them. And it'll be significant to your kids and your wife, knowing the things that you've done. For the last month, this is the best lunch I've had. So I appreciate that. So I appreciate Piper and Marott and all of you that have sponsored tables that allow this to happen and the staff that puts all this together. It's a lot of work, and we appreciate that. Appreciate the mayor. It's significant. Dr. Hampton and I were talking yesterday. A lot of the responsibility that we have as leaders is just to show up. And it means a ton for you to be here, Mayor, so we appreciate that. I hope that you last a long time. It used to bring me, I used to enjoy it when you see the emails about the people that have been on our pension for 35 and 40 years. So I hope that for all of you, probably not so good for the city, but I hope that for all of you. I do want to recognize Ricky Newell's family. His wife and his son are here. He passed away just recently, just retired. Always had a smile on his face. So thank you for being here. It means a lot. So thank you for being here. I wish the best for you. So does the police department. We are always your family. If there's anything that we can do, my door is always open. I can't do much, but there's plenty of people on the police department that I can direct and that actually can. So please, if there's anything you need, make sure you get in touch with us. Thank you.
I would like to invite FOP President Rick Snyder to the podium for special presentation acknowledgments from the FOP Lodge 86.
Well, good afternoon. We're honored to help sponsor this, but to also join you today in helping to recognize some special circumstances within the membership of our FOP Lodge, and that's for those who have had over 32 years of active membership within the FOP. That's quite an accomplishment and does not go unnoticed. Incidentally, this year at this ceremony, we have a member who unfortunately is not here with us today, but that I did want to recognize, which is Lou Christ, who has had 51 years of active membership in the FOP, and is, which is absolutely remarkable. Now today, those who have 32 years of active membership in the FOP or more will receive an FOP watch from the membership of the FOP. And as our immediate past president liked to say, it's no coincidence that the brand of the watch is Fossil. So that was always his line. So he's with us in spirit, of course. But what I would like to say to you is that our hope is not only for you, but for others who may not have had that many years, that you still recognize the value that we place on the time that you have had not only in support of this city and the work that you have done for your fellow citizens, but the work through the FOP that you have also done on behalf of your fellow officers and their families. And so I hope that you view the symbolism, the symbolic nature of the watch that several of you will receive today in accordance with that thought. And I share with you from the book of Ephesians, I thought this was important. It says that as a plan for the fullness of time, to unite all things in Him, things in heaven and things on earth. And it just really represents the fact that regardless of how you believe, what faith you may be from, I can assure you we all in this room recognize this one thing, is that every single one of you who have retired and who are currently working feel that this profession isn't a job, it's a calling, and that you came forward and answered that call for a higher purpose and a higher call in your life. And I hope that that's what this these watches, this discussion of time represents to you. You truly did God's work here on earth for your fellow citizens. And that should never be overlooked, should never be devalued, even with the challenges we face as a country right now. You, each and every one of you, made a difference. And don't ever forget that. So with that, let's proceed with the ceremony. If it's okay, we'll just jump in as you call those people. Again, these will be for folks who have 32 years of active membership or and over. I'll present it with the plaques, if that's okay. I'll call them out real quick, just so we know. We have Steve Burke with 32 years, Alfred Watson with 32 years, David Peace with 33 years, Rick Burkhart with 34 years of FOP membership, Randy Nave, where's my buddy Randy, 35 years, Bill Miller with 35 years, and then Joe Humke and Lou Chris, who are not here. Joe had 36 years, and again, Lou Chris had 51 years of FOP membership. So if we could give all them a round of applause. In closing, if there's anyone here that feels that maybe we overlooked time or whatnot, please feel free to reach out to us. I'm joined today by Pam Warren from our office, who many of you know is our receptionist and who helps organize all this. She can also help me if you have any questions, make sure that we get that remedied, okay? So congratulations to everyone, and we wish you nothing but the best. And don't forget this, you're still always welcome at the FOP. We definitely would love to have you as a retired member of the FOP if we don't already. And you and your family always have a home there. Thank you.
I failed to mention brief for Rick Snyder as well. So, all right, we're going to go ahead with our program and start with our civilians, starting with Mr. John Mattingly. He was appointed to the police department or park rangers in 1995. In 1999, he was promoted to the rank of sergeant. In 2002, he was promoted to the rank of lieutenant. In 2006, he was promoted to the rank of captain. And in 2007, he was appointed to the rank of administrator of the park rangers. John retired at the rank of major after serving 21 years with the park rangers. Thank you, Major Mattingly. Major Mattingly, if you'd like to share a few words, feel free.
I really don't.
Yes, sir.
That's as brief as you'll have.
Yes, sir. Starting with our next and beloved, Jerry Snitko. She was appointed to, here's some claps already. She's appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1979. She was assigned to Investigation Division as a clerk typist. What is that, Jerry? A clerk typist. In 1980, she was assigned to the Office of the Chief, Internal Affairs. In 1985, she was assigned as the Chief's Complex Secretary. Chief, can we call it the Complex? Yeah, I like that. In 1986, she was assigned as Assistant Chief Secretary. In 1992, she was assigned as Chief Aide. In 1997, she was appointed as executive assistant to the chief's office. Executive assistant. In 2016, Jerry retired after 36 years of continued service with the city of Indianapolis and the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you very much, Jerry. Jerry, did you want to share a few words?
Maybe later.
Maybe later. She's got plenty to share. We're going to skip out of the program just a bit here to accommodate a schedule. We're going to go with Bill Lohr, who was appointed to the Marion County Sheriff's Department in 1986.
It's all about
Bill. I just dropped the mic on that one, huh? In 1987, he was assigned to Road Patrol. In 1992, he was assigned to Investigation Division. In 1995, he was assigned to Homicide Robbery Section. In 2003, he was promoted to the rank of Sergeant, assigned to Property Crimes. In 2005, he was appointed to the rank of Lieutenant and assigned to the Covert Assistant Section Supervisor. In 2002, he was assigned to Arson. In 2008, he was assigned to Homicide Robbery Branch. In 2011, he was appointed to the rank of Deputy Chief of Investigations for Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. In 2012, he was appointed to the rank of Assistant Chief. 2013, he was appointed to the rank of Deputy Chief of Investigations. In 2006, Bill Lohr retired at the rank of Deputy Chief after serving 29 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Chief Lohr.
The chief told me to be brief. Thank you.
All right. Mike Bates was appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1986. He was assigned in that same year to George Sector. For some of you old timers, what's George Sector now? Anybody know what George Sector is? South, yep. There you go, there you go, very good. 1990, he was assigned to Special Services. In 1993, he was promoted to the rank of Sergeant and assigned to East District. In 2000, he was promoted to the rank of Lieutenant and assigned to North District. In 2003, he was assigned to the Traffic Branch. In 2008, he was appointed as Traffic Branch Commander. In 2010, he was appointed to Homeland Security Branch Commander. And then in 2016, he retired at the rank of Deputy Chief after serving 30 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Chief Bates. Chief Bates, would you like to share comments?
No, thank you.
I was told to ask you that. We will continue with Stephen Burke. He was appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1984. In 1985, he was assigned to Quadrant 1, which is North District. In 1986, he was assigned as a field training officer. In 1987, he was assigned as a general detective. In 1992, he was assigned to the organized crime. In 2001, he was assigned as a cyber crimes detective. In 2009, he was assigned as a PAL officer. In 2015, he was assigned to professional development. And in 2016, Stephen Burke retired at the rank of patrol officer after serving 32 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Officer Burke. Would you like to say anything, sir?
I said enough.
Yes, sir. Might be the best part of the program. Richard Burkhart. Yes, I am. Right there. He was appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1982. In 1983, he was assigned to the Old Frank Sector. In 1986, he was assigned as a sex crimes detective. Left there for a brief stint in homicide in 1991. In 1996, he was assigned as a sex crimes detective, where he stayed until his retirement in July of 2016, where he retired at the rank of detective after serving 33 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Detective Burkhart. Nobody wants to say anything. Next, we'll continue with Donna Soselski. She was appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1984. And at that same time, she was assigned to Frank's sector. In 1989, she was assigned as a family abuse neglect investigator. In 1991, she was assigned to a trial advocacy investigator. In 1992, she was assigned as an organized crime investigator. In 2004, she was assigned as a cyber crimes investigator. In 2013, she was assigned as a forensic investigator. And in February of 2016, Donna retired at the rank of patrol officer after serving 32 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Donna Success. Terrence Kress, appointed to the Marion County Sheriff's Department Jail Division in 1986. In 1997, he was appointed to the Law Enforcement Division of the Marion County Sheriff's Department. In 2007, after the merger, he was assigned to Southeast District, where he stayed until his retirement in August of 2016. Officer Kress retired at the rank of patrol officer after serving 30 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Officer Kress. James Forrest was appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1989. In 1990, he was assigned to Quadrant 2. In 1993, he was assigned to East District Detectives. In 1995, he was assigned to South District Detectives. In 2001, he was assigned to North District Detectives. In 2002, he was promoted to the rank of Sergeant. In 2009, he was assigned to North District, where he stayed until his retirement in April of 2016. James Forrest retired at the rank of sergeant after serving 26 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Sergeant Forrest. Jay Groh, appointed to the Marion County Sheriff's Department in 1974. I was like 2 years old. In 1977, he was appointed to the Law Enforcement Division of the Marion County Sheriff's Department. In 1986, he left for a brief moment and assigned to the range. In 2007, he was assigned to North District. He retired in May of 2016. Jay Groh retired at the rank of patrol officer after serving 42 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Officer Groh. All those long talks you gave me in roll call, you don't want to say anything? Wow, I'm just so surprised. Detective Gregory Hagan, signed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1996. In 1997, he was assigned to West District. In 2002, he was assigned to East District. 2008, he was assigned to the robbery unit. In 2010, he was assigned to the aggravated assault unit. In 2011, he was assigned to the homicide unit. In 2015, he left and went to financial crimes until his retirement of May of 2016. Gregory Hagan retired at the rank of detective after serving 20 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Detective Hagan.
I've waited 21 years for this. My story is actually about Chief Roach that I wanted to share with the mayor and everybody. Brian and I go back to 90, 91. I was loading trucks at UPS. Brian was my supervisor, so even back then he had leadership skills. I was the top producer on the belt, of course. I loaded faster than anyone. And one night, Brian walks into my trailer. He's got his stopwatch out and he's counting my productivity, and he goes, "You're down a little bit tonight, Hagan." He walks away. I let it go. He comes back again, same routine. I turned around and snapped at him. Brian jumped up in the truck with me and helped me load to get the volume done. That's the type of leader he was back then.
Continuing with our program, Chief David Hoffman, my classmate, was appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1997. In 1998, he was assigned to North District. In 2000, he was assigned to South District. In 2005, he was appointed to the rank of, or promoted to the rank of sergeant and assigned to South District. In 2008, he was assigned to internal affairs as an internal affairs investigator. In 2000, he saw a lot of me. Saw a lot of me in 2011. In 2011, he was assigned to career guidance and development. In 2013, he was promoted to the rank of lieutenant and assigned as a crime specialist on South District. In February 2014, he was appointed to the rank of commander, where he stayed until January of 2016, where Dave Hoffman retired at the rank of commander after serving 18 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Chief Hoffman.
So 18 years, I feel so inadequate to stand here in the company of all those who have served 51 and 41 and all those numbers. But I just want to say there's very few people in here, maybe some family members of officers who I don't know. But I know, as I look around, I'd say almost everybody in here. And you have all had an amazing impact on my life and my career that led me to make probably the most difficult decision, and that is to leave IMPD to take this new position as chief in Lawrence. And I'll just say, I kind of feel like, I wouldn't miss this luncheon for anything, but I don't feel like it's over in my case, because I look forward to working with Chief Roach, with Josh Barker, my commander to the west of Lawrence, and Roger Spurgeon, the commander to the south, and continuing our great partnership that we have. And I'll tell you, I accepted the appointment to the Southwest District commander spot, and it was then Commander Roach who got bumped up to assistant chief, who really nurtured me and helped me grow into that commander position. And as I look around, I see so many other people who were so influential. Danny Overly was critical to me in my decision to leave IMPD and take this new position. Chief Soselski sent me to the National Academy, which I believe truly made me eligible for this position. So I'll shut up now. Chiefs do tend to go on and on, but I just want to say thanks to everybody, because I'm not who I am without all of you in this room. So thanks. There was one more. The guy who really started it, I don't know if you remember, Bill Miller was my background investigator, and he came to my house and interviewed me and my wife to make sure I was a good enough guy for IPD. So thank you.
So Dave, we have you to blame, huh? We'll continue on. Cynthia Jenkins, appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1986. In March 1997, she was assigned to Quadrant 4. In February 1989, she was assigned as a sex crimes detective. In May of 1997, she was assigned to the Property Recovery Unit. April 2010, she was assigned as a pawn officer until her retirement in July of 2016. Cynthia Jenkins retired at the rank of detective after serving 30 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Timothy Knight, appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1992. In April of 1993, he was assigned to North District. In August of 1994, he was assigned to the homicide unit as a homicide detective. In February 2003, he was promoted to the rank of sergeant and assigned to the aggravated assault. In October 2004, he was assigned to the OK program of Indiana. In May of 2014, he was assigned to East District. Until his retirement of April of 2016, Timothy Knight retired at the rank of sergeant and doctor after 23 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Sergeant Knight. Sergeant Knight, you have no words. I'm shocked. William Miller, appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1981. In September 1991, he was assigned to Quadrant 2 as a middle shift officer. In March 1987, he was assigned to the chief's office as a personnel background investigator. In 1993, he was assigned to Operations Division, Downtown District, as a foot patrol officer. In 1996, he was assigned back to the chief's office again as a background investigator. And then in March in 2012, he was assigned to the Professional Standards Division as a medical liaison officer. until his retirement of May of 2016. Bill Miller retired at the rank of patrol officer after serving 35 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Randy Knave, appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1981. That same year, he was assigned to Quadrant 2 Middle Shift. In 1992, he was assigned to North District Detectives. In 1995, he was assigned to investigations as a fraud detective. In 1999, he was assigned to the prosecutor's office as a prosecutor office assistant. In January 2002, he was assigned to the vehicle theft unit. In May 2003, he was assigned to financial crimes unit as a fraud investigator. And then in July 2016, Randy Knave retired at the rank of patrol officer after serving 35 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Our next is Ricky Newell, who tragically passed away February 14, 2017, while in Florida with family. Here on his behalf is Sergeant Newell, his wife, Kay Newell, and his son, Kevin Newell. He was appointed to the Marion County Sheriff's Department in 1986. In 2000, he was assigned to the Investigation Division of the Marion County Sheriff's Department. In 2007, he was assigned as a vehicle theft supervisor. December 2007, he was assigned to Southwest District as a middle shift supervisor. In July 2011, he was assigned to Southwest District Detective Sergeant. March 2016 is when Ricky Newell retired at the rank of Sergeant after serving 20 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you for your service. Next up is Deanne Pulley. She was assigned to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1989. That same year, she was assigned to Quadrant 3, late shift. In 1991, she was assigned to the Traffic Division as a hit-and-run investigator. In 1992, she was assigned to South District Detective Unit. In 1996, she was assigned to East District Day Shift. In 1999, she was assigned to West District as a field training officer. In 2001, she was assigned to the Downtown District Parking and Intersection Control. In 2002, she was assigned to the Traffic Division as a sickle officer. In 2003, she was assigned to South District Day Shift. In July 2016, she retired at the rank of patrol officer after serving 27 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you, Deanne. Next up is Timothy Snyder. He's appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in 1993. In August of 94, he was assigned to South District Middle Shift. In 1995, he was assigned to North District. In 1997, he was assigned to West District. In 2001, he was assigned back to North District Narcotics Unit this time. In 2005, he was assigned to Investigation Division as a dangerous drug investigator. In 2003, he was assigned to North District Middle Shift. In 2009, he was assigned to Downtown District Late Shift until his retirement of April of 2016. Timothy retired at the rank of patrol officer after serving 22 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Next up is Alfred Watson. Appointed to the Indianapolis Police Department in July of 1984. In 1985, he was assigned to the Operations Division, Quadrant 2. In December 1998, he was assigned to Investigation Division as a vehicle theft investigator. In 1990, he was assigned to Gang Unit as a gang investigator. In 1993, he was assigned to North District Day Shift. In 2001, he was assigned to East District Day Shift. In 2005, he was assigned to East District Detective Unit, where he remained until his retirement in June of 2016. Alfred retired at the rank of patrol officer after serving 31 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you. 32 years.
2 years
as a reserve. I tell you, police are always technical. Certainly, last but not least, Mark Wood. Mayor. Appointed to the Marion County Sheriff's Department in 1995. In 1996, he was assigned to the Administrative Division. In 2003, he was appointed to the rank of Sergeant and assigned to the Investigation Division. In July of 2004, he was appointed to the rank of Lieutenant and assigned to the Executive Division. In 2005, he was assigned to the CLIA Accreditation. In 2011, he was assigned to Northwest District as a Crime Specialist. In 2014, he was assigned as the Operations Executive Officer. In February 2016, he was assigned to East District Day Shift. Until his retirement in September of 2016, Mark retired at the rank of Lieutenant after serving 21 years with the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. Thank you. Let's give all of our retirees another round of applause. Next, I'd like to acknowledge the beautiful ensemble that many of you heard at our social just across the hall. That music was provided by the L.E. Newsom String Ensemble, has been sharing its musical offering since 1975. The ensemble is named for its founder, the late Dr. Laverne Newsom. Dr. Newsom, the first African-American violinist to play for the Indianapolis Philharmonic Symphony, was a brilliant violinist who played with numerous orchestras, chamber groups, and soloists. Can you give them a round of applause? And I'd like to acknowledge members of that band as Tim Bratton, Marble Lewis, Francis Gray, Sharon Henry, who is the mother of Officer Justin Henry, who's East District, Michael House, Muriel Treadwell, and Angela Cooper. Let's give them another round of applause. I would like to thank again Sarah Haas of Pipers at the Marott and her staff and all of the wonderful supporters and sponsors who make this day possible. I would also at this moment like to acknowledge Ms. Sabrina Young for her assistance. I think Ms. Sabrina's back there. With her assistance with the table centerpieces, aren't they beautiful? You are welcome to take the flowers from the table centerpieces. However, please leave the flower vases on the table. Okay, that makes sense. So you can take the flowers, but give it to the oldest retiree at your table. That's the way my boss has told me to say that part. So, all right. With the most years. Seniority with the most years. There you go. I'm probably, that wasn't in my script. Next, I'd like to acknowledge, before we end, Ms. Donna Forrest for her wonderful work putting this affair together. Before we end, I'd like to end with this poem, and then we'll bring up our chaplain for the benediction. It's called, I Can Still Matter. As time passes on, I turn the next page to discover a new me while I continue to age. I may no longer be who I was long ago, but I can still matter, that much I know. With a new set of tools I have gathered from time, I keep looking forward to more mountains to climb. My best is not over, as the skeptics might say. I just learned how to conquer in a much wiser way. So don't sell me short, I'm not nearly done. I can still matter, I've only just begun. I would like to bring back our chaplain for our benediction.
Okay. I got a little nervous when Ernie took the microphone because he promptly reminded me. He asked me what year I came on and then said, oh wow, I was two. So I was scared to death of what he might say. If you would please join me in an attitude of prayer. To everything there is a season, a time to every purpose under heaven. God, we thank you for the season that our retirees have come through. We thank you for your protection and for your guidance. We thank you, Lord, that you kept them. And now, God, we ask that you would do the same in their new season, that your hand of protection would be upon them, that you would guide them, that you will forever bless them and their families, as they have been a blessing to this city. We honor the work that they have done, and we honor you. In his name we pray, amen.
Thank you for our retirees. Please stop up and get your box. Thank you, everyone. Have a great rest of the day.